Just record a little bit. Excuse me, it's early in the morning here, not Germany time.
Yeah, it's only 9:05 here. And so 9:05 where you're at too.
Same thing,
it's 6
yeah.
PM.
So I thought I took a ninja avatar, but I look like a woman. Is there a way I can see what I look like?
The ninja avatar is an interesting phenomenon.
It's a remnant of our last Halloween party, but now I see you as a female avatar with a skirt, and so you changed it probably.
I did not. I picked the ninja, so I was surprised I came out as a female.
Yeah, that the ninja avatars, one of them comes out. We have a guy that we work with all the time named Selby Evans, and Selby has his own avatar. And one of the ninjas come out as Selby, and I guess one of them comes out as that. So okay. The ninja ones are surprise.
Got it.
Maybe I messed some ideas up in the database.
Is this based on some of the OpenSim code? Is this? It looks like a little bit OpenSim, or.
No, I created everything from scratch, so it means in the back end you simply have an Apache web server with PHP and a database, and the front end is a pure JavaScript with WebGL and WebRTC for voice communication.
It's very simple. I mean, it's basically just a fancy 3D web page.
So I produce in a handful of web-based worlds, and so I'm curious. Like, I produce in Mozilla Hubs, which obviously doesn't have this amount of polygon resolution. For a scene,
yeah.
the memory size is often a challenge when you're dealing with a web browser. So I guess...
Well, that's the glass ceiling.
Right. How are you serving this, then? And how would you, I produce virtual events. Right. So if we got a group of people in here, the load would be tremendous. How would that even work for you?
No, just the point is it's more or less built like a peer-to-peer virtual world with a central dispatcher. So it means most of the load is on the clients, not on the server.
Got it. And if I'm a guest, can I make items in a room or is that not a capability?
No, only for registered users, because when you are a guest, you have no real user ID. And to make things persistent, I have to attach objects created with a user ID.
Oh, I like the camera control. That's useful.
Yeah, and the point is, for example, we have built-in tools for creating things. The whole scene you are seeing here, this was all created in-world with the existing tools. So you don't need any external tools to create things. Everything you see here was created in-world on the fly.
How do I get out of the camera mode that I'm in?
with the escape key.
Escape key. Okay, got it. Okay, great. Thank you.
When in doubt, escape.
Okay, so the owner can make changes to a location.
I can see
a map. There are different rooms and locations that I could go to. I see. Yep. And here's my avatar choices.
Yeah, and also if you have a registered user, you can also create new animations for your avatar, so you also don't need external tools. These are all built in, so you don't have to leave the web page. You can build things in here. You can change, like that's your avatars. You can communicate with people. You can bring in content simply by dragging and dropping things. For example, if you want to share a PDF, you just drag it from your desktop in here and everybody can read it.
Got it. Drag and drop. That's nice.
Yeah, well, the other thing is if you have an OpenSim region, an OR file, you can take that OR file and convert it using Convor and make it into a GLTF file, and then you can drag and drop that GLTF file into CyberLounge.
So for being able to do models or an avatar that's sculpted, or is that for objects or for personas, for avatars?
it works for everything. So literally everything which is supported, you can simply import by dragging and dropping. So drag and drop works for 3D models. It works for avatars, or you can also import a whole region. So it means setting up a new region as a copy of an existing one only takes a couple of seconds.
Yeah, got it. And I guess it's then a memory size challenge, right? It has to be a certain size in order for it to load.
Yeah, but for example, also this region here has only, as a zip file, it's about 4 megabytes. A complex region has something between 50 and 100 megabytes. So it's not, also, it's a bit of a challenge, but it's not that much.
Everybody, the virtual worlds move 2019.
Also still, like usually, the avatars are taking up most of the memory.
You have a video of my old world in here. I had helped build the nonprofit commons in Second Life. So I turned on a video and I was like, wait, that's my work.
I already presented my work at the nonprofit commons.
Right. So I was the original builder on that for TechSoup back in 2006, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11.
Back in the grand old days, yes.
Right. So I've been doing this for a long time. I used to produce mixed reality for U.S. State Department and many, many, many organizations over the years.
Yeah, the problem is, that's why I came up with the idea to create something new by myself, is the problems with Second Life and OpenSim is usually, if you are in an institution or in a company, you cannot access an OpenSim server through the firewalls. You have to open many, many ports. So that was the idea, to have something. If you are able to reach the internet, you can use my virtual world.
That makes sense. So I guess that brings up like 3 other questions for me.
Okay.
I'm very curious to try things. So I guess if I wanted to build my own experiences here, it would be becoming a registered user. And then what does that look like?
That's all. You just have to register. Then you have. Then I can assign you a region. Or Steve also is hosting this platform, so we can provide you a free region, and then you can simply do whatever you want with this region. It's 512 by 512 meters, and there is no prim limit. So it means, in principle, you can use edge masks, prims as your browser allows you.
Right. So I guess it's more of a file size and load limit versus a you have to use this number of polygons.
Yeah. Exactly. So in principle, if you use complex models, this will take up more memory and, of course, will make things slower. If you're really a good prim builder.
Right. If you know how to do something
create,
lightweight.
Or with a little.
Because too complex of a build, I'm guessing you can't have a lot of avatars in here. What's your avatar load limit?
Yeah, that's like you said, it depends on the memory the browser gives you. I've made load tests with about 30 to 40 avatars.
That's great. And can you run a live stream in here, or is it just static media?
No, it means if you have a YouTube live stream, which is embeddable, you can also stream it. We have also live audio streaming. So it means you can even attach your own internet radio channel and stream it into the world.
Right. So I do mixed reality, and I sometimes do those via Twitch. So then it would just be putting the URL in, and it would automatically load in.
Yeah. So for example, if you have building rights, you just have to click on the video presenter and drag the URL from your browser address bar into the world, and the source of the video is automatically changed.
So what do you want to most see happen with this new world that you've created? What are you excited for?
Yeah, so currently we are, we already did a pilot project with a university here in Germany, and 400 students did their group work in virtual rooms.
Education and commercial uses. Education is really the first thing we're looking at.
Right.
And Also, I am working, my company is a Dimension Beyond Incorporated, and we're a hosting service, and we're also a development company. But because of this virus thing, I realized that everybody's holed up in their houses, and communication isn't easy.
Right.
So, for an example, in my town here, Prescott Valley, Arizona, in Prescott, the town next door, we have a parade every year around July 4th. Well, the group that's putting together that parade, which I kind of feel isn't going to happen this year, but we're still working on it. And that group needed a way to meet. So I set them up a room, okay, so that they can all stay at home, hunkered down, and they can get together and do what they need to do.
Well, and I'm imagining actually working with high schoolers here in California to help them create their proms and graduations, because they need a space to have their gatherings, and we've been asked to help produce those, but none of the platforms we've looked at are really great for that, and we wanted to have something that wouldn't require them to pay, you know, $5 a person, basically, to cover the cost, to go to their own graduation. It's challenging, because obviously you can't have more than 40 people in here, and most platforms can't support large groups. There's only a few that do.
Well, yeah, let's say it this way. Large groups usually are not the perfect target for a virtual world, because, you know, if 40 people are talking, then you have pure chaos.
But, it's much better to do small dance club rooms and then connect them, I found. So this is what we did with the Cloud Mixed Reality event, was we had 4 rooms in Neos VR, we had the Twitch room, and then we had a dance club in Mozilla Hubs. And so each room ended up with like 20 people in it.
And this is also the perfect solution here for the web world, because the thing is, the regions itself don't cause any load on the server, only if people are present. And this is a thing, for example, we have a non-profit server which runs on a single CPU with 512 megabytes of RAM, and we already had groups of 20 people there without any issues.
It doesn't require a heavy-duty server at all, but it does require a server that isn't distracted. I put it on a rented server. It's a relatively cheap one. It was like $9 a year. And the servers that it's on were, I think, incredibly overloaded, and I was having load issues.
Right.
Everything was doing weird things. And I took it and put it on my own server down in Phoenix. And now it's running just fine.
Makes sense.
So the key is, it's got to be a server that's got connected to a really good connection, and it should be a not distracted server, overloaded server.
Yeah, but you see, that the server you are currently on is hosted here in Germany, and still it's in a professional data center, and so there's almost no latency. Voice is routed over a free switch server hosted on AWS.
Right. Yeah, that's exactly how Mozilla Hubs does it. So if you buy the private cloud service, it's an AWS dedicated solution.
Yeah.
And that worked well. We just did IEEE VR conference for 1,600 people that way. And so we could lock down the experience. And you know, you had to, you know, be logged in on that server in order to participate. Interesting. This is fascinating. I'm absolutely fascinated by your work, Ed.
Thank you.
Where in Germany are you?
Excuse me?
Where in Germany are you?
A couple of miles away from Munich.
Excellent. I was conceived in Germany, but not born there. My parents came back to the U.S. I wanted to be born in Germany, but they... I would love to stay in touch with you. I'm on the Facebook group as Evo, so it's pretty easy to find me. But my team is at Playable Agency, and we produce a pretty wide variety of virtual experiences and events. We also do experiential, immersive, physical builds as well as virtual. So, and we have a team of both educators, but game developers and theater directors and creators, both 2D, 3D, and XR, VR. So if you end up needing...
That sounds interesting.
Yeah. We've been building a mega team here in California to take on a number of these experiential challenges even before this most recent adventure that we're all on together. I guess I'm curious about other types of events and use cases. So I would love to stay in touch with you and maybe if you have documentation of other events that you've done.
Yes, of course. And also what we have is every 2 weeks we have a developer talk where we discuss what's in my on my plan for the next features, or even where people can bring in their ideas. Because the good thing is, as a single developer, I'm very it's very easy for me to shift some priorities. And for example, if you demand a feature which is not too difficult to implement, you can have it with the next patch in a week or two later.
Makes sense. I'm playing with the camera controls as we talk, Ed, just so that I can get a sense of. I used to shoot a lot of machinima, and I still do, but it's, I gotta say, extremely challenging in most worlds to shoot good machinima. And so I'm testing out, like, can I control a camera in here? Can I actually shoot? Because that was one of the biggest frustrations for this recent conference I just did.
Yeah, but that's something. So if you have great, or if you have ideas for a perfect camera control, you just have to tell me, because then I will try to implement it. And regarding machinima, the next thing I will add is to have bots. So it means you can script avatars and attach some animations to them.
So right. It would be great. For instance, like I'm looking at you right now, and your head is just doing this very gentle back and forth.
Yep.
I'm focused on you right now. Could you show me if there are other animations that you could do while you're in this chair, or is it that because you're in the seating animation, it can't do other
animations? It's a sitting animation, because this is one other, or something we do different than other virtual worlds is, it means there are no animations attached to the avatar itself. So right. The avatar is just a skinned mesh with a skeleton and bones.
Right.
And and the animation is then a kind of infused to or fused to the avatar. So it means the chair tells the avatar what to do.
Right. So it's going to be a single animation at one given time. If you stand up, you would do different animations, but it's going to have one.
Exactly. So if you stand up, if you do the idle animation. If you walk, you do the walk animation. But you can always change the animation. So it means every user can create their own idle animation and apply it to the avatar.
Right. And more like Second Life was. I understand that.
Yes. And my next on my feature wish list is to have thing called blended animations. So it means that, for example, if you are talking, then you still have the sitting animation, but arm and mouse movement will be blended into that animation. So you can have more animations applied at the same time, and the result is a blend of all these animations.
That's amazing. All right, I am going to